there.
This is Shelley Johnson.
I'm here with my really good friend Sharon Terhune, who's also a fellow athlete at Elemental Gym. So I've been kind of bribed. I think Sharon's going to treat me to a dirty chai if I let her do a quick interview today. So here's my friend Sharon
Excellent.
Terhune.
Shelley, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Hey.
All right, so it's your turn now. You've interviewed a bunch of us, right? Mm-hmm. Athletes from Elemental Training. You've been with Steve since last March. You made the decision to go with him. I made the decision to go with Jago and some friends a month before that in February. I love how you've been keeping track of yourself. You've lost like an amazing amount of fat, gained muscle, lost weight. So many of us have made the decision to get fit and make some changes in our life, and your results have been pretty dramatic compared to some of us who are growing, and I feel great about myself, but there's a difference. So talk to me about what you did differently, because we all made this decision.
Well, okay, but first of all, for the record, you're doing awesome. I think you're doing great. And also, for the record, I do think it's important for me to point out that it was you that kind of put me over the top and got me into Elemental Gym. So thank you for that.
Bar, though, now I kicked you over the top, and then you raised the
you
bar.
You created a monster.
Right.
So,
well, give me the secret.
You know, there is no secret. Okay, this is what gets me. You're not the first one to say, "Oh, you know, you're special," or "What's your secret?" You know, I think I'm not special. I think what makes it different is that I really, for some reason, on March 23rd, I committed. I mean, I did. I like to say that there's a difference between deciding and committing. Okay, and so let's say from 2005 all the way until March of 2009, which is a little over 3 years.
Yeah.
Every night I decided tomorrow I'm going to change my life, because I had kind of gotten into a rut, gotten kind of fat and soft and lazy and definitely not healthy. 3 years, I bet you every single night, I'm not exaggerating, I decided tomorrow's going to be different, I'm going to finally start exercising, get healthy again. I didn't do it.
So, you probably made some specific decisions, right? I'm going to eat less.
I'm going to exercise regularly starting tomorrow.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm going to eat healthy starting tomorrow. I did this for 3 years, every night, I bet. Not a single night went by, I bet, when I didn't promise myself I was going to change.
Okay, but then,
so the difference is, for some reason, I don't know why, on March 23rd, I had just had enough. And I did. I changed my life, and I said, I am not turning back this time. I am so tired of this heavy feeling of regret every night.
So
I'm
it's
not,
interesting
I'm tired
that
of hearing myself say that I'm going to do something and not,
and
do
not
it.
And I don't remember the date.
Well, I just know it was March 23rd, because that's when I finally met with Steve Bechtel. I employed him as my personal trainer. And that's probably what jump-started it, made it more official. But from that point on, I changed everything, you know?
So
I want to talk a little bit about deciding and committing, because, okay, so we do this as people all the time. We decide we're not going to drink as much, or we're not going to drink, and then we go to a party 1 week later, and someone offers you wine, and it's like, well, okay, you know? And this is what we do. I'm going to quit biting my nails, and then the next day I'm biting my nails, or I'm going to quit eating chips, and then there's chips at a party. And we're weak. I mean, we're weak as people.
Okay,
so
on the evening of March 23rd, or maybe the 22nd, how was the self-talk differently? How did it sound different than
help is on the way. Help is on the way. That's the best way I can describe it. After I had met with Steve, he didn't tell me anything I didn't know, but I officially signed up, not an official contract, but that's kind of the way it felt.
Yeah.
And I just said to myself, I am not going to bed one more night with this regret. It just was awful to me. And I knew that no amount of hard work would be as awful as that feeling I had every night for too long now. So, That's the big difference. I think you have to really say, you can't just decide. That's the first step, but you have to say there is no turning back.
So the next time it happened that you were offered whatever food or drink that could have tempted you,
and it happens still today.
Did you remind yourself, wait, I've committed?
I did. And let me tell you, I think this is a secret to my success, is that you have to be tested. You can't say, I'm going to give up chips and then never ever be around chips. I mean, that's helpful, but it's not realistic.
That's right.
So
kind of fake.
I think these little tests, the first time someone offers you chips, or I go to my parents' house and we're having a big feast, I mean, I want to eat those potatoes, but I had made this commitment, and that little test right there, am I going to have these potatoes or not? And I said no. To me, that's a small victory. It sounds stupid, but...
But are you asking yourself, all right, so Shelley, am I going to do it? No.
Yeah, I'm not so much anymore, but for weeks and weeks I did, several times a day. I mean, when the boys and Jerry are having Texas toast at dinner or tortellini, you know, I'm not eating it. So there were several days when, am I going to do it? Yeah, that question comes up, and I say, no, I'm not going to do it, because I think about how it's going to make me feel versus how I feel if I say no and have something healthier.
And I bet results were motivating, right? As you probably saw some quick results.
No question. I saw results because I attacked it from every angle. It wasn't easy. I probably chose the hardest way, I think, because I'm impatient.
Yeah.
But I have to tell you that feeling the way I do now, which, number one, I'm sure I've lost a lot of weight, and I'm sure I look probably better than I did 10 months ago, but more than anything, I have more energy, and I just know deep down that I'm healthier because I'm taking care of myself. And to me, I can tell you 100% that everything is better. Every single thing in my life is better right now because of those changes I made. Every single thing, you name it, it's better.
So you don't ever foresee the slide down the back end of this mountain?
Well, I will never. You've asked me that before.
Yeah.
What if you fall into that rut again? And to me, it's is unconscionable a word?
Yeah.
To me, it's not an option. I will never let it happen. I've tasted the Kool-Aid. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it's and there's too much at stake. You know, not only for myself, but I've got three young kids, and an adventurous husband, and there is a lot of at stake for me. I'm not just saying this. I want to be able to keep up with my boys. I want to be able to get on the floor and have our two-year-old tackle me. I mean, these are things that, you know, I couldn't do very comfortably.
And doesn't it feel great to walk through your life and say, yeah, I'm succeeding. I'm doing this. I feel great about myself.
It feels wonderful. I mean, and that is the reward. Going to bed without that regret is huge.
Yeah.
I can't emphasize that enough. I mean, it's been all the difference to me. So,
are you going to keep going?
I am going to keep going.
You're still committed.
I'm still committed. More than ever, I've got a 25K skate ski race, just something to kind of keep me performing at a high level. I've got the pull-up goal. I've got major, long, epic day hikes I want to do here in our backyard in the Winds.
Yeah.
I mean, I just want to keep getting stronger and fitter, you know, as long as I can. I want to live until I'm 41 years old, so technically I'm probably maybe at the middle of my life.
Yeah.
And
I don't want
that to be my middle of my life.
Yeah.
You know? So.
And does it feel great to you to be able to go shopping or put anything in your closet on, right? And know.
It's totally awesome. In fact, I'm glad you brought this up because I have some cowgirl tough jeans. I never thought I'd be excited about jeans, but a friend of mine, a colleague that I work with, Bill Garrels, he hooked me up with a pair of cowgirl tough jeans. They've got bling on the pocket. And I tell you what, I never in a million years would have thought that I would want to wear them or that I probably could wear them.
Yeah.
And it's a small thing, but it's kind of exciting to, you know, be able to think I could wear some cool looking jeans. So, but the other thing I wanted to mention has to do with swimsuits and not wearing a bikini or anything like that. But it seems like a minor thing, but it's a big thing to me. My boys, their favorite thing to do is swim. We travel a lot, and every time we go to a hotel, and over the past several years, I've never gotten in the pool. And it's...
Because?
You know, I wasn't comfortable in a swimsuit. You know, and sure, I might have looked fine, but I didn't feel fine. And to me,
because
it's really
sad. Because for the record, you were never...
I had gotten overweight.
Okay, but you could have had a swimsuit on, but you didn't feel comfortable doing it.
Definitely not for me. And this is a big deal because I missed out. You know, I'd sit at the pool, but they were in there splashing with their dad. And now I'm going to go in the pool and be playing with the boys now. And I think there's a lot of parents out there. I don't want to speak for other parents, but I'm pretty sure there are mothers and fathers out there that aren't getting in the pool with their kids.
Yeah, they live on the sidelines. I think you're going to keep going. You're going to keep blogging. You're going to keep videoing. We'll see the Shelley progress, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yeah, you'll keep me honest.
All right.
I hope everyone keeps me honest.
We'll keep you honest. So well, thanks for being on the other side of the camera, Shelley. It's about time.
Thanks. I appreciate all the support and everything.
All right.